Okay, welcome back. In today's class, we are going to do direct and indirect speech. Why we are doing direct and indirect speech after completing these tenses, you know? Yes, because direct and indirect is a play with the tenses. Okay, right? How it becomes a play with the tenses, that we will discuss soon. But before that, let us examine what is this direct speech and what is this indirect speech. Quite clear? In a direct speech, we directly report what the speaker said in the speaker's own words. And in an indirect speech, we report what the speaker said, not in the speaker's words, but in our own words. Okay? We can report what a person says in two ways, isn't it? Which are the two ways? So, in one, we directly report what the speaker said in the speaker's own words, isn't it? As he is spoken, so he is reported. And in another manner also, we can report what the speaker says. What is that? In an indirect manner. I will show you one example, then it will become quite clear to you. See this. John said, I am ill. John said, I am ill. This is direct speech. You know that. Why? Because here we are directly reporting what John said in John's own words, isn't it? But we can report what John said in our own way also, isn't it? Then what we will get? John said that he was ill. John said that he was ill. Very simple. When we say John said that he was ill, what are we doing? We are reporting what John said, not in John's words, but in our own words. Okay, quite clear. So this is that speech, and this is in that speech. Very clear. So when we report what the speaker said in speaker's own words, it is that speech. When we report what the speaker said, not in the speaker's words, but in our own words, it is called indirect speech. In an indirect manner, we introduce things. But in that speech, we simply borrow the speaker's words and simply report what he said in his own words. That is all. So, when we change a sentence from direct into indirect, like this, we must remember five rules. How many rules? Five rules. All these five rules, invariably, you must remember. Otherwise, you will go wrong while you do this particular exercise. Okay, let us see what are the five rules to be observed. Okay, when we change a sentence from direct into indirect. First rule is change of tense. I already told you, direct and indirect is a play with the tenses, isn't it? So, first rule itself is change of tense. These are the five rules that you have to bear in mind when you change a sentence from direct into indirect. First rule is change of tense. Second is change of persons. Third is change of all kinds of sentences into a statement. Then change of certain words and removal of inverted commas. Okay, let us see what are these changes, how we have to work out all these. First rule, change of tense. We have already seen tenses are broadly classified into three: the present tense, the past tense, and the future tense. And each tense has got four forms, so totally we will get to 12 tenses. We have already studied it. Now, let us see what change occurs to tenses when we change a sentence from direct into indirect. Okay, I will tell you, please listen carefully, what is the change that occurs to tenses when we change a sentence from direct into indirect. Okay. When we change a sentence from direct into indirect, all the present tenses will go to the corresponding past. When we change a sentence from direct into indirect, all the present tenses in the direct speech will go to the corresponding past. Corresponding past means if the direct speech is in simple present, it will go to simple past. If the direct sentence is in present continuous, it will go to past continuous. If it is in present perfect, it will go to past perfect. If it is in present perfect continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. Quite clear? Okay. Then, if the direct sentence is in the past, then you must be a little bit careful. If the direct sentence is in the present, no problem, simply change it into the corresponding past. But sometimes the direct sentence itself might be in the past. If the direct sentence itself is in the past, what change will happen to it? Let me tell you. If the direct sentence is in the simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the direct sentence is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the direct sentence is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. If the data sentence is a simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the data sentence is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. And if the sentence is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, they remain unchanged. Okay. And if the direct sentence is in the future tense, what will happen? Nothing. Simply use the auxiliary would. Whatever future tense it might be, whether it is simple future, future continuous, or future perfect continuous, whichever future tense it will be, simply use the auxiliary would. We will do one example, then things will become quite clear. See this sentence. Sunil said, I cook food. Sunil said, I cook food. This sentence is in simple present, you know. So, let us apply our change of tenses to this sentence and let us change the same sentence into all the tenses and find out how this transformation occurs. Then, Sunil said, I cook food. Sentence is in simple present. According to our rule, simple present will go to simple past. Isn't it? All the present will go to the corresponding past. If the data sentence is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the data sentence is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. If the data sentence is in past perfect and past perfect continuous, they remain unchanged. And in future, whichever future it is, we will use would. So, this is the change that happens to the tenses, isn't it? So, now let us apply all these tenses here. Sunil said, I cook food. What will be the indirect? Sunil said that he cooked food. Sunil said that he cooked food. I became he cook. Simple present became cooked. Okay, right. Suppose this sentence is in present continuous. Then what will be the sentence? I am cooking food. Sunil said. Then what will be the indirect? Sunil said that he was cooking food. Okay. Present continuous will go to past continuous. Suppose the sentence is in present perfect. What will be the present perfect of this? I have cooked food. If the data sentence is in present perfect and if it is I have cooked food, what will you get in that? Sunil said that he had cooked food. Okay. Then Sunil said, I have been cooking food for the last 12 hours. I have been cooking food for the last 12 hours. Okay, present perfect continuous. If it is in present perfect continuous, it will become past perfect continuous. And what will you get in indirect? Sunil said that he had been cooking food for the last 2 hours. Okay, go to symbol. If the direct speech is in present, it will simply go to the corresponding past. But if the direct sentence is in the past tense, you must be a little more careful. Why? See, if the direct sentence is in simple past, what will be the simple past of I cook? It will be I cooked, isn't it? Yes. If the direct sentence is cooked, C-O-O-K, if it is cooked, then in what tense you will have to convert it? Past to perfect. For the direct sentence is in simple past, it will go to past to perfect. Then how will you get? Suril said that he had cooked food. Suril said that he had cooked food. Suppose this is in past continuous direct sentence. I was cooking food. So if Sunil said I was cooking food, what will you get in indirect? Sunil said that he had been cooking food. If it is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. If the direct sentence is in past perfect, past perfect means had plus past participle of the verb, isn't it? So, if the direct sentence is, I had cooked food, if Sunil said, I had cooked food, what will happen? Nothing will happen. If the direct sentence is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, they remain unchanged. Because whether this past perfect can go to still more past? Is there any still more past there? No. Whether past will go to future? No. So, there is no any other tense to go, isn't it? So, if the direct sentence is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, they remain unchanged. So, what will you get here? Sunil said that he had cooked food. Sunil said that he had cooked food. Tense remains unchanged. And if it is past perfect continuous also, remain unchanged. I had been cooking food. Sunil said I had been cooking food. What will be the indirect? Sunil said that he had been cooking the food. No change. In past, only simple past and past continuous will be changed. Past perfect and past perfect continuous remain unchanged. What will happen to future? Okay. Sunil said, what will be the future? I shall cook food. Suppose the sentence is in the future, simple future. Sunil said, I shall cook food. Then what will be the indirect? Yes, it is simple. Sunil said that he would cook food. Whatever future it is, simply use the auxiliary would. Okay, right? So, shall also will become would here. Why? Because shall is used with the first person, isn't it? This first person becomes third person here. So, naturally, shall also will become would. Whatever tense or whichever future tense it is, we will use would. Okay, let us see the other future tenses. Sunil said, I shall be cooking food. I shall be cooking food. Future continuous. Suppose the sentence is in future continuous. Then what will you get? Same. Simply change would. Remaining thing is the same. Sunil said that he would be cooking food. Sunil said that he would be cooking food. Suppose Sunil says it in future perfect. Then how will he say? Sunil said, I shall have cooked food. I shall have cooked food by that time. Okay. I shall have cooked food by that time. Suppose, Sunil said like that in future perfect. Then what will you get here? Same, simply change. Shall will become would, that is all. remaining same. Sunil said that he would have cooked food. He would have cooked food by that time. Okay. So, future perfect. And if it is future perfect continuous, that also the same. I shall have been cooking the food. Okay. If it is in future perfect continuous, that also will be like this only. Only would will be there. Then you will get Sunil said that he would have been cooking food. He would have been cooking food. Okay. So quite clear. So this is the change that occurs to tenses when we change a sentence from direct into indirect. All present will go to when we change a sentence from direct into indirect. If the direct sentence is in the present, it will go to the corresponding past. If the direct sentence is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the direct sentence is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. If the direct sentence is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, they remain unchanged. And in future tense, or in all the future tense, we will use would in the indirect speech. And if we have auxiliaries like can, may, etc., what will happen to them? They will also go to the corresponding past. Can, may, etc. will become could, might, etc. Okay. So if you have any auxiliary like this, that will also go to the corresponding past. For example, John said, "I can cook food." Instead of saying, "I am cooking food," John said, "I can cook food." Then what will you get in indirect? John said that he could cook food. John said, "I may cook food." Then what will you get? John said that he might cook food. Okay, quite clear. So this is the first rule, change of tenses. Okay, so but there is one exception from this rule. There is one exception from this rule. What is that? Yes. I will write some two sentences. Then you tell me in what manner you will change it into indirect. Whether you will observe the change of tense in that context. Please tell me. Okay. Copernicus, you know, a great astronomer like our Galileo, Ptolemy and all. Copernicus said, "The earth moves around the sun." Copernicus said, "The earth moves around the sun." How will you change it into indirect? Copernicus said that the earth moves around the sun, or Copernicus said that the earth moves around the sun? Copernicus said that the earth moves around the sun. This will be the condition when we change this kind of sentence. What is the speciality with this sentence? This sentence tells us a universal truth, isn't it? The earth moves around the sun. So, whenever we have to report or change this kind of universal truth or general truth, etc., from direct to indirect, don't change the tense. Because these are true at all places and at all times, isn't it? General truth, universal truth, it is beyond time and space, at all times and at all places, it is true only, isn't it? So, in such context, we should not change the tense. Understood? So, Copernicus said, earth moves around the sun. Indirect also will be open, you can say that the earth moves around the sun, because now also it is happening. Let us see another sentence. The teacher said. The teacher said. Water boils at 100 degree Celsius. The teacher said, water boils at 100 degree Celsius. Here also, this sentence is telling us a general truth, isn't it? A fact that is true everywhere, at all times and at all places, isn't it? So, when you change this into indirect, what will you get? Yes, the teacher said that water boils at 100 degree Celsius. But so this is an exception from our rule. So whenever we report or whenever we change this kind of sentences that tell us a universal truth or general truth, don't change the tense. The tense has to be retained as it is. Okay, quite clear? Okay, right. Okay, suppose the direct reporting verb itself is in the present, then what will happen? Till now we discussed sentences in which the reporting verb was in the past, isn't it? Now, if the reporting verb itself is in the present, what will happen? Let us see. Sunil says. Instead of said, we have says here. Sunil says some three sentences. Okay, I did that, I am doing that, and I shall do that. Suppose Sunil says these three sentences. I did that, I am doing that, I shall do that. What will happen? Sunil says that. Sunil says that I will certainly become. I certainly becomes he. Sunil says that he did that. Should we change the tense here? No. If the reporting verb is in the present, the following verbs may be in any tense that the context requires. If the reporting verb is in the present, the following verbs may be in any tense that the context requires. Okay, right? So, no need of changing the tense. Simply change the person and convert it into indirect speech. So, Sunil says that, he did that. Here, Sunil says, I am doing that. Sunil says that, he is doing that. I will become is, isn't it? Since I becomes he. So, Sunil says, he is doing that. Sunil says, I shall do that. What will be there? Sunil says that he will, shall will become will. Why? Because I becomes he, isn't it? So, Sunil says that he will do that. No change of tense occurs here. Okay, so be very careful about all these things. The reporting verb is in the present. The following verbs may be in any tense that the context requires. Okay, right? So, these two things you must bear in mind when we report a universal truth or general truth. Don't change the tense. And if the reporting verb is in the present, the following verbs in the indirect speech may be in any tense that the context requires. Okay, right, clear? Let us go ahead. Yes. Now let us go to change of persons. You know, there are three persons, first person, second person and third person. First person is I, second person, first person is I and is plural we, second person you, third person he, she, it, they. You know that? So, what change occurs to these persons? Let us see. Okay, the symbol. All first persons go to third person. All first person goes to third person. Second person goes to either first person or into third person. Second person goes to either first person or into third person. As per the demand of the context. Then, if we have a third person pronoun in the direct speech, it remains unchanged. Remains unchanged. So, this is the change of the persons. First person will go to third person, second person will go to either first person or into third person, and if we have a third person pronoun, it remains unchanged. Okay, I will detail the change of these persons with the help of some small symbol diagrams. See, first person. Let us see one sentence. Okay, let us see the change of first person first. Sunil said, I am ill. Sunil said, I am ill. Here, what you have? First person singular, I you have. What will you get when you change? Sunil said that he was ill. I will become he, I will become was, isn't it? So, first person became the third person singular, he. Suppose, instead of Sunil, you have Sunita, a girl is there. Then what will you get? Sunita said, I am ill. Sunita said that he was ill or she was ill? She was ill. Sunita said that she was ill. So, she was ill. That was okay. Suppose Sunita said, Sunita cannot say, if we want they, we must change the subject. They said, what they will say? They said, we are tired. They said, we are tired. Here we have first person plural we. What will happen when we change? They said that they were tired. Isn't it? We become they. So, this is how first person changes. First person goes to third person. First person singular I go to third person. Singular he or she. First person plural we go to third person plural they. Very simple. Okay. Now let us see how the second person you will change. Second person you will become either first person or third person. Let us see one example. She said. She said to me. She said to me. You are selfish. She said to me, you are selfish. How will we change? She said to me that, second person you, what will happen? She said it to me, to whom? To me. So here, the reporter, the speaker and the character in the direct speech is one line saying, isn't it? So, when the reporter and the character in the direct speech is one and same person, you will become what? You will become I. Isn't it? She said to me that I was selfish. What truth? Second person became first person singular here. Because here the speaker and the character in the direct speech is the same person. She said to
us instead of me. Suppose we have us. She said to us, you are selfish. How will we get? Very simple. She said to us that instead of I, what will be here? We will have we. She said to us that we were selfish. We are selfish become, you are selfish become, we were selfish. Because here it is plural. She said to us that we were selfish. Okay, you become we there. Suppose she said to, she said to him, she can tell the same sentence to anybody, isn't it? She said to him, you are selfish. She said to him, you are selfish. How do you change? She said to him that he was selfish. What root? Here, second person became third person singular, he. Suppose, she said it to her. She is saying to our girl, she said it to her, you are selfish. Then what will you get? She said to her that she was selfish. That roots. So, she. Then, she said it to them. She said to them, you are selfish. How will we get? She said to them that they were selfish. She said to them that they were selfish. Okay, quite clear? So, this is the change of the first and second person. So, first person goes to third person, second person goes to either first person or into third person according to the demand of the context. If we have a third person pronoun, it remains unchanged. Let us see one sentence. Gopal said, okay, he was a good man. He was a good man. Gopal said, he was a good man. In the direct speech, what pronoun you have? A third person pronoun. Third person remain unchanged. So, just to change the tense only. So, Gopal said that he, same pronoun with her, he was. It is in simple past. It will go to past perfect, isn't it? He had been. Was will become had been. Because in past perfect, had will be there and the past participle of the verb will be there. What is the past participle of was? It is been, isn't it? Okay. So, Gopal said that he had been a good man. Suppose you have she here. Another third person. She was a good player. She was a good player. Then how will you get? She said that. Gopal said that. She will be there. She had been a good player. Okay. Then, suppose you have they here. She said, they are very friendly. She said, they are very friendly. What person you have? Third person plural. So, Gopal said that, they were very friendly. No change. So, the same pronoun will be there. Then, suppose you have it. It also is a third person pronoun, isn't it? Okay. Gopal said, it is a good dog. Gopal said, it is a good dog. What pronoun you have here? Yes, You have third person singular it. It also remains the same. Gopal said that it was. It is will become it was. Gopal said that it was a wood dog. Okay, clear? So this is the change of persons. So quite simple. If we have first person, it will go to third person. If we have a second person pronoun in the direct speech, it will go to either first person or the third person. And if we have a third person pronoun in the direct speech, it remains unchanged. Okay, right, clear? Then, let us go ahead. What is next rule? Change of all kinds of sentences into a statement. This is an important rule. Change of all kinds of sentences into a statement. How many kinds of sentences are there? You know, there are four types of sentences. Assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence and exclamatory sentence. Isn't it? Assertive sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a statement. We are learning direct and indirect speech. Isn't it? We are living in Tamil Nadu. Isn't it? And these are statement. So, such a sentence is called assertive sentence. What is interrogative sentence? Interrogative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a question. Isn't it? What is your name? Where are you going? When will you come here? Are you happy? So, yes or no question, question or question. All kinds of questions are interrogative sentences. Then what is imperative sentence? Imperative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a command, request or wish. Command, request, wish. Imperative. Isn't it? Bring the criminal. March forward. Shoot him. Isn't it? Command. Please help me to lift this. Will you please show me the way to airport? Request. Isn't it? Then wish. May God bless him. Or may devil take him. Or happy Diwali. Isn't it? So, all kinds of wish. Also belong to imperative sentence. Imperative sentence are sentences which express command, request, wish, etc. Then what is exclamatory sentence? Exclamatory sentences are those sentences which show a sudden feeling. Exclamation, surprise, horror, fear, excitement, enthusiasm. All these kind of what a hot day, isn't it? How beautiful the bird is. What a pity. How dirty the room is, isn't it? So, all kinds of sentence which shows a sudden feeling belong to exclamatory. So, you might have already studied all these things. So, whatever be the sentence, whether it is assertive, interrogative, imperative or exclamatory, whether the sentence is a command, request, wish, question, exclamation, whatever be the sentence in the direct speech, everything will become a statement. Everything will become a statement in the indirect speech. So, this is a very important rule. So, when we change all these kinds of sentences into a statement, we have to take into account certain things. We have to use an appropriate introductory word. We have to use an appropriate link words, etc. When we change a sentence from direct into indirect, whatever be the type of the sentence, all kinds of sentence will become a statement. Then different kinds of introductory words and link words we have to use. Then what are those link words, what are those introductory words that we have to use when we change different kinds of sentences, I will show you with the help of a table. Okay. So, this is the changes and these are the words that we have to use when we change different kinds of sentences from direct into indirect. We have to see what kind of introductory word must be used. We have to see what proper link word has to be used. All these things we have to take into account. So, let us do all these things, taking some examples. Then you will understand it fully. So, let us start with the assertive sentence. Assertive sentence, I already told you, assertive sentence is a sentence which is in the form of a statement, isn't it? So when we change a statement, what are the common introductory words that we use? Said, told, etc. What will be the link word? Link word will be that. Let us see an example. She said, I am unhappy. She said, I am unhappy. I am unhappy is an assertive sentence, isn't it? Okay. What introductory words we have to use? Said or told. Said is already there. So, simply add that here. What is this that? Link word. What do you mean by link word? Link itself means connect, isn't it? Link word is that word which links or connects what is within inverted comma and what is outside the inverted comma. What is link word? Link word is that word which links or connects what is within the inverted comma and what is outside the inverted comma. Okay, so in different types of sentences, we have to use different kinds of link words. Okay, so here she said that she was unhappy, isn't it? So, introductory word is said, link word is that. Okay, okay. What is this introductory word? Introductory word means the word with which we introduce the indirect speech. Okay, right. So, we have to introduce the indirect speech with different kinds of words. Who tells whom what? Who tells whom what? Accordingly, we have to use the appropriate introductory words when we change different kinds of sentences from direct into indirect. Okay, right. She said it to me. I am going to the railway station. She said it to me. I am going to the railway station. Okay, you change? Very simple. She said it to me. You can use same set or you can use told also. She told. After thought, there will be not to. She told me. She told me that. She told me that she was going to the railway station. Okay, right. So, when we change statement, usually said and told will be there. But when we change interrogative, imperative, exclamatory sentence, etc., different kinds of introductory words will be there. Who tells whom what? Accordingly, we will have to use different kinds of introductory words. Okay, let us see what are the different introductory words that we have to use in different contexts. Okay, right. Let us go to interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentence, we know. Interrogative sentences are sentences in the form of a question. Question word question, yes or no question, all kinds of questions belong to interrogative sentences. Now, let us see how we can change questions from direct into indirect. She said it to me, when will you return my money? Direct sentence is a question, interrogative sentence. How will you change? Yes. She said it to me. Can you say she said it to me when you change a question? No. Which word you have to use? Ask. Because this is a question, isn't it? So, who tells whom what? Accordingly, we have to use appropriate introductory word. She asked me, when will you return my money? So, when we change questions, what will be the link word? Link word we already discussed. Link word is that word which connects what is within inverted comma and what is outside the inverted comma, isn't it? When we change questions, what will be the link word? If it is a question word, question like this, the same question word same question word must be used as single word. And whether or if in case of yes or no questions. If it is question is yes or no question, we must use whether or if. If it is a yes or no question, whether or if. If it is a question word question, same question word. When, were, why, how much, how far, what are the question word? It is same question word must be used as single word. So here it is a question word question. So this same question word we will use. So how we will get? She asked me when. When will you return? When I would return her money. How you will get? She asked me when I would return her money. Isn't it? She asked me when I would return. When will you return? Isn't it? You become I. Because here speaker himself is the character. So it goes to the first person. She asked me when I would. Can you say when would I? No. Because in a statement the auxiliary verb will go after the subject. In question it will come before the subject. In question auxiliary will come before the subject. But in a statement, possibly will go after something. So, you have to say, she asked me when I would, not when would I. So, she asked me when I would return, my money will become her money. Okay, right? So, this is how you have to change a question. Let us see another question. My father said to him, where are you going? How will you change? Here also you have question word question. So same question word will be used as single word. So said must be replaced with asked. But here, where are you going? More than asking, it is an enquiry. Where are you going? So the most appropriate word will be enquired. So my father enquired him, where are you going? Where are you going will become where he was going. My father inquired him, where was he going, is wrong. As I already told you, in a statement, the auxiliary verb will go after the subject. So, my father inquired him, where he was going. After where he was going, will you put a question mark or full stop? Full stop must be there. Our rule is change of all kinds of sentence into statement. Question, exclamation, comment, request, everything will become a statement. Okay, right. So, this is how you have to change a question from direct to indirect. If it is a yes or no question, you have to use whether or if. Okay. She said it with me. Will you come with me? What kind of question you have? Yes or no question. Isn't it? So, it is not a question word question. This is a yes or no question. Will you come with me? Yes or no? That will be the answer. Isn't it? Okay. How will you change? Yes. When you have this kind of yes or no question in the direct speech, you have to use whether or if. Whether or if. So, very simple. She said to him. Said to him will be replaced with asked. She asked him. She asked him whether he would go with her. So many changes are happening here. Change of certain words. Change of sentence into statement, many things are happening. So, will you get? She asked him if or whether he would go with her. She asked him if or whether he would go with her. Will you come with me? Whether he would go with her. Okay, right. This is how we have to change. questions from direct and indirect. Okay, so the introductory word will be asked, inquired, etc. And the link word will be the same question word. If it is a question word question, it is yes or no question, whether or if. Okay, now let us proceed. Imperative sentence. Imperative sentence, I already told you, imperative sentence is a sentence which is in the form of command, request, wish. So, if we have command, request, wish, etc., how can we change from direct to indirect? Okay, very simple. So, let us see the command first. The king said, hang the criminal. The king said, hang the criminal. Command. So, what will be the correct introductory word? Asked, ordered, commanded, requested, advised, warned, suggested, who tells whom what. Accordingly, we have to use the appropriate introductory word. Here, of course, king always give command or order. So, said will be replaced with ordered or commanded. The king ordered, hang the criminal. So, what is the ling word? Can we use that here? No. Can we use question word? This is not a question. So, when we change imperative sentence, command, request and all, what will be the ling word? To or not to. If it starts with the don't, then we will use not to. If it is a open command like this, simply use to. Okay, so very simple. The king ordered, simply add to. That is all. Don't do any other thing. The king ordered to hang. The king ordered to hang the criminal. That is all. Okay, right. The major said, march forward. March forward. The major said, march forward. The major commanded to march forward. The major commanded the troops to march forward. So, simply add to. Okay. The mother said to son, do your homework regularly. So, what will be the correct appropriate introductory word here? Whether a mother will command to son, no need. Whether mother will request, no need. So, asked, ordered, commanded, requested, advised, warned, suggested. Out of this, which one is most appropriate in this context? The mother asked the son, isn't it? So, here said the two will be replaced with asked. The mother asked son, simply are two. That is all. The mother asked her son, or mother asked the son, to do, your will become his, isn't it? Mother asked the son to do his homework regularly. Very simple. The doctor said it to patient. Doctor said it to patient. Don't drink too much. The doctor said it to patient, don't drink too much. So, this is said, will be replaced with what? Doctor, command, doctor will command, doctor will simply ask, doctor will request, if you drink, I will die, doctor will die. So, doctor usually advise, isn't it? So, who tells whom what? Accordingly, we have to. The doctor advised, A-D-V-I-S-E-D, advised the patient. The doctor said this will be replaced with advice. The doctor addresses the patient, don't. If the imperative starts with don't, we must use not to. Not to. Okay, don't is there, not to. We have to use. So, the doctor addresses the patient not to drink too much. Not to drink too much. Okay, right. So, who tells whom what, accordingly we have to use the correct word. Want suggested many words are there. Want. Let us see, your a warning can be given. They said to him. They said to him. Okay. Beware of dogs. They said to him. Beware of dogs. So here said must be replaced with what? Beware of dogs. It's a kind of warning, isn't it? So what will be the correct word? Want. They said it will be replaced with want. They want him. Simply add to. They want him to beware of dogs. So they want him to beware of dogs. Okay. Then suggested. When will we use suggested? When we have some suggestion. So when we have suggestion, be a little more careful. See the sentence. The husband said it to wife. The husband said it to wife. Let us go for a film this evening. The husband said to wife, let us go for a film this evening. So what is this? This is a suggestion, isn't it? So whenever we have a suggestion in direct speech, we must use the introductory word suggested. So said to will be replaced with suggested. The husband suggested the wife. The husband suggested the wife, let us go for a film. If let us is the, you must use that they should. So if let us is the, you have to always use this construction, that they should. So the husband suggested wife that they should go for a film that evening. Okay, so this is how we change suggestion. So this is how we are changing imperative sentences from direct into indirect. So many introductory words are the ing word is to and not to. Now let us go to the last one, that is exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence, you know, exclamatory sentences are those sentences which express a sudden feeling, surprise, excitement, enthusiasm, fear, horror. Different moods are conveyed through these exclamatory sentences. What are certain introductory words that may occur here? Exclaimed, wondered, wished, prayed, cried with joy, cried with sorrow, cried with fear, shouted, many, many. Who tells who what accordingly? Different kinds of introductory words we have to use here also. And the ling word is that only. Just like the assertive sentence. Okay, right. So let us do some examples. Then it will become clear to you. Okay. The professor said, what a hot day. So, this is said must be replaced with what? He is not simply saying, he is making an exclamation. So, exclaimed. So, we have to use the word exclaimed. The tourist exclaimed that, ling word will be that. The tourist exclaimed that, what a hot day. No. What is our rule? Third rule, change of all kinds of sentence into a statement. Everything will become a statement. What a hot day means, the day is very hot, isn't it? So, that meaning we have to reproduce here. So, how will you get? The tourist exclaimed that, the day was very hot. The day was very hot. The tourist exclaimed that the day was very hot. Okay, So, the exclamatory sentence has become a statement here. Then, wished, prayed, many things will from here. Happy Diwali. Happy Diwali. She said it to me. Happy Diwali. She said it to me. How will you change? She said it to me, Happy Diwali? No. She wished me. She wished me Happy Diwali. She wished me. She wished me Happy Diwali. Full stop. No exclamation mark. Nothing will be there. Everything is becoming a statement, isn't it? So, she wished me Happy Diwali. Okay, right. Then, cried, cried with joy, cried with sorrow. Many, many different kinds of introductory words are here. Who tells whom what? Accordingly, we have to use it with the C verb. Prayed will come. See the sentence. The priest said. The priest said. May God save. May God save the king. May God save the king. So, is a wish. How will we change? Here, said must be replaced with what? Prayed. The priest prayed that. The priest prayed that God might. May will become might. The priest prayed that God might save the king. Okay, so here prayed comes. Then let us see another sentence where something cried with joy, cried with sorrow, etc. also is coming here. Cried with joy. See the sentence. The interjection that expresses joy is hurra, H-U-R-R-A-H. It is hurra only, not hooray. Some people pronounce it hooray. It is hurra only. Hurra. We won the match. We won the match. We won the match. Hurra, we won the match. A Pakistani said from the gallery. Said from the gallery. Okay. So, hurra, we won the match. A Pakistani said from the gallery. How will we get? A Pakistani, is it simply saying? No, this is, which word will be suitable here? Cried with joy, cried with fear, cried with sorrow, shouted. So two words are possible here. Either you can use shouted or you can use the word cried with joy, isn't it? So a Pakistani shouted. A Pakistani shouted from the gallery that we won the match. We won the match will become we. First person will go to third person. We won. It is in simple past. Simple past will go to past. Remaining words are same. Simple past will go to past perfect. So they had won the match. Okay, so a Pakistani shouted from the gallery that they had won the match, or a Pakistani cried with joy from the gallery that they had won the match. Okay, so who tells whom what? Accordingly, we have to use. Then cried with the sorrow. With the sorrow, what is interjection that is used to express sorrow? Alas, isn't it? She said. She said, alas, the poor woman died in a road accident. So, can you reproduce the word alas, hurrah and all? No, you have to convey the same idea through the appropriate introductory word, isn't it? So, what will be the correct introductory word here? Said last. So, said must be replaced with what? Cried with the sorrow. So, she cried with sorrow that, she cried with sorrow that the poor woman died. Simple past will go to past perfect. Had died. She cried with sorrow that the poor woman had died in a road accident. Okay. So, is quite clear. Okay. Now, let us examine the next rule, that is change of certain words. When we change a sentence from direct into indirect, some words will undergo change. What is that change? Yes. Words showing nearness will become words showing distance. These are certain words that get changed when we change from direct into indirect. Very simple. Words showing nearness will become words showing distance. Very simple. This, that, these, those, here, there, now, then, today, that day, tomorrow, the next day, or the following day, yesterday, the previous day, or the day before, day after tomorrow, after 2 days, the day before yesterday, 2 days back or 2 days before, come will become go. Remember that. A go before this, so. So, in this way, words will get changed when we change from direct into indirect. So, we will check this change in a sentence. I will write a sentence having many of these kinds of words. In what manner they get changed, let us see. Will you come here tomorrow wearing your sari in this manner? So ladies, sometimes instead of wearing like this, sometimes they will wear like this. Okay, so Lucy and Susie has no other problem. So, will you come here tomorrow wearing your sari in this manner? Okay, Susie. Okay, so this is a dialogue, conversation between Lucy and Susie, who are very much concerned with these kind of things. Will you come here tomorrow wearing your sari in this manner? Susie, sorry. I am going for the inauguration of Ansi's fancy shop tomorrow. So, how will you change this dialogue? Many words showing nearness will become words showing distance. Many of such words occur here. That is why I wrote this dialogue. Okay, let us see. Lucy asked Susie, isn't it? This is a question. What kind of question is this? It is a question word question, isn't it? So, when we convert a question word question from direct into indirect, we must use whether or if, isn't it? That we already discussed. So, Lucy asked Susie whether you, second person will here become third person because you stand for Lucy, whether she, isn't it? Since this is a yes or no question, we must use whether. So, Lucy asked Susie whether she will become what? Will become would. Isn't it? You go to past. Whether she would come. Come will become go. So, whether she would go. Here will become there. Whether she would do go there tomorrow. Tomorrow will become the next day. The next day or the following day, isn't it?
Lucy asked Susie whether she would go there the next day wearing your saree. Your saree will become her saree, isn't it? Wearing her saree in this manner. In this manner will become in that manner. It will become that, isn't it? Then question mark will not be there, full stop will be there, isn't it? Because our third rule is change of all kinds of sentences into declarative, isn't it? Please remember all our theory. Now we are putting our theory into practice. So Lucy asked Susie whether she would go the next day wearing her saree in that manner. So see how many words are undergoing change, isn't it? So becomes go, then here become there, tomorrow becomes the next day, this became that. So many words are getting changed in this sentence. So this also you must bear in mind, the change of certain words. Anyway, what answer Susie gives? Sorry, I am going for the inauguration of fancy shop tomorrow. Susie regretted. Sorry means expressed sorrow and said that. Or Susie regretted that he was going, she was going. Present continuous, past continuous. Susie regretted that she was going for the inauguration of Ansi's fancy shop. Tomorrow will become the next day. Isn't it? So, what are the following? So, this is how some words get changed. So, it is very simple. So, if you remember what change occurs to certain words, you can easily do that. Then, let us go to the last rule. Last rule is nothing. Always, last rule is what? Removal of inverted commas. Always a direct speech is put within double inverted comma, isn't it? When we change it into indirect, we remove the inverted comma, that is all. So, Shyam said, I am weak. Shyam said, I am weak. So, just before the direct speech, there will be one comma and the direct speech will always be within double inverted comma. Isn't it? Removal of commas. So, we will have to remove all these kind of commas when we change it into indirect. What we will get here? Shyam said that he was weak. Full stop. Isn't it? Is there any comma here? No. So, this is also nothing. A rule concerned with punctuation marks. That is all. Now, we completed all the five rules. Change of tense, change of persons, change of all kinds of sentences into a statement, change of certain words, remove of inverted commas. All the five rules we have completed. Now, let us put these rules into practice. What rules? There must be some applicability for theory, isn't it? Let us put our theory into practice. I will write some dialogue, some 2-3 dialogue. I will give you some 2-3 minutes. Within that 2-3 minutes, you do it yourself. You change the sentence from direct into indirect. And when I discuss, you just compare your answer with the answer that I tell you when I discuss it. Okay, right? Okay, see the interesting conversation between a poor father and a modern son. Okay. Did you buy my medicine yesterday? No. Why? Because I had no money with me. Don't you know that those medicines are so essential and urgent to me? Yes, I know. Then when are you going to buy it? I shall buy it when I get my salary. When will you get your salary? I will get my salary after 20 days.
By that time I will have died. So this is interesting dialogue between a father and son. Now you apply all our rules here. All the 5 rules must simultaneously work in your mind, otherwise you will go wrong. But the tragedy with most of the people is that when they remember one rule, they will forget 2 rules. So unless and until all these 5 rules simultaneously work in your brain, you will go wrong. So make the theory practical here. I will give you some 2 to 3 minutes. You just try to change this dialogue into indirect speech by yourself. And when I discuss this, you compare your answer with my answers. Okay, so now you just pause your video and you just take some 2 to 3 minutes and do it yourself. Okay, whatever answer you get, you just compare your answer with my answers. Okay, right, your time starts now, right? Okay, over. I think you successfully completed the task. Okay, let us see. You just go through your answers and you just see what answer I am discussing here. Father. Father is asking, son, isn't it? Did you buy my medicine? What is the tense? This is question, isn't it? What is the tense of question? Did you buy my medicine? Simple past, isn't it? So, according to our rule, simple past will go to past perfect. Remember all the rules. And this is what question? Is it a question word question? No. It's a yes or no question. Did you buy my medicine? So when we change a yes or no question, we must use whether or if, isn't it? So remember all and change. Let us start. Father asked the son. Father asked the son whether. Father asked the son whether you will become he. Whether he did buy. It is in simple past. It will go to past perfect, isn't it? Father asked the son whether he had bought. Simple past will go to past perfect. Whether he had bought my medicine will become his medicine, isn't it? Father asked the son whether he had bought his medicine yesterday will become the day before or the previous. His medicine the previous day. His medicine the previous day. Okay. Then, father asked the son whether he had bought his medicine the previous day. Son, no. If you have no, how will you convert? Can you reproduce the same no in indirect? No. You have to write replied negatively. If no is there, you must write in indirect replied negatively. If it is yes, replied positively. Okay. Son replied negatively. Right. Then, father, why? How will you convert why? Can you reproduce? Father asked why. Can you write in there? No. So, why? Why means asked the reason. Why will become what? Asked the reason. So, the words that reproduce the same meaning. Words that reproduce the same meaning you must bring. Because you cannot directly quote the same word. Because you are converting from direct into indirect. Okay. So, father asked the reason. Son, I had no money with me. Son replied that I had no money with me. I had no money with me is in which tense? Simple past. It will go to past perfect. So what will you get here? Son replied that he had no money with me will become no money with him. Son replied that he had no money. Why had? Past perfect. What is structure of past perfect? Subject plus had plus past participle. Isn't it? First head is auxiliary verb, second head is main verb. Okay, right. So, son replied that he had no money with him. Father, don't you know that those medicines are so essential and urgent to me? Again, yes or no question? Father, don't you know that? He shows his anger, fury, isn't it? So, that also must be reflected. Father, again furiously asked him. Father again furiously asked the son, Don't you know? Don't you know? It is yes or no question. Don't you know, isn't it? Whether or of, you have to use. Father furiously asked the son whether he, don't will become didn't, isn't it? Whether he didn't know. Whether he didn't know that those medicine, those is those only. This will become that, this will become those. But if you have those, it remains unchanged. Okay. So, father asked son furiously whether he didn't know that those medicines were so essential and urgent to him. To him. Okay. What's up? When you change sentence from direct to indirect, all sentences will become statement. Command, question, request, everything will become a statement. Only full stop will be there. And when you write it in indirect, you have to write it in a paragraph. Understood? In a para, you will have to write it like this. Don't write one after the other like this. In a para, you have to write it then. Anyway, father asked the son furiously whether he didn't know that those medicines were so essential and urgent to him. Son, yes, I know. Son replied positively. Father again asked him, then when are you going to bite? Father again asked him when he was going to bite. Father again asked the son when he was going to bite. Then you can omit that for just for logical connection in dialogue, then was used. Father again asked the son when he was going to bite. Son, I shall bite when I get my salary. Son replied that he would bite. I shall will become he would. So son replied that he would bite when I get my salary. When I get my salary will become when he got his salary or when he would get his salary. Both are correct. Son replied that he would bite when he got his salary or when he would get his salary. Okay, right. Father, when will you get your salary? Father again asked the son when he would get his salary. Father again asked him when he would get his salary. Okay. What is son's reply? Son replies that I will get my salary after 20 days. I will get my salary after 20 days. Son replied that he would get his salary after 20 days. Very simple. Then what is the last dialogue? Very unfortunate dialogue of the father. By that time I will have died. Father, by that time I will have died. His sorrow is there. Impatience is there. So his helpless state, that is what is reflected. So it is an impatient reply that he gives. By that time I will have died. So you can change like this. Father replied impatiently. Father replied him impatiently. Father replied him impatiently, or father replied son impatiently that replied him that by that time I will have died. I will have died. I will become he. Will become would. That is all. Father replied impatiently that by that time he would have died. Okay. So this is how you have to change a sentence, dialogue, etc. from direct into indirect. All the five rules should simultaneously work in your brain, otherwise you are bound to go wrong. Okay, let us do one more dialogue, or two more dialogue we will do, because the more we practice the better. Okay, right. Okay, let us go through this conversation between a tourist and a man. The tourist is requesting the man to show him the way to airport, and the dialogue takes place between them. The tourist: hello, will you please show me the way to airport? Sorry, I don't know the way because I don't belong to this place. Who can help me if so? You go and ask that auto driver. One auto driver might be standing there. You ask that auto driver. He may know the way because auto drivers know all the ways. Okay, okay, thank you. So, this is a dialogue between tourist and a man. So, very simple. I think you can do it. I will give you 1.5 minute time. Within that time, you can do it. And when I discuss the answers, you just compare your answers with what I discuss. Okay, right? Your time starts now. Okay, over. Right. Let us go through it. The tourist: hello, will you please show me the way to airport? It is a request. Even though this is a question, it is actually a request, isn't it? Here a request is put in the format of a question. Understood? Yes. So long as there is an element of request, you must treat it as a request only. Okay. The tourist asked or requested. It will be requested. Even though apparently it is a question, the spirit of that question is a request only. A request put in the frame of a question. Okay. The tourist requested the man. Hello, etc. are just for dialogue style only. You can drop it. The tourist requested the man whether, will you, when you treat it as a question, you must treat it as a question even though meaning is different. So, the tourist requested the man whether, this is yes or no question, isn't it? So, it is whether you will become what, you will become he, whether he would show him. Please, will you add please also? No. This is please. This meaning is already coming in requested, isn't it? So, the tourist requested the man whether he would show him the way to airport. Very simple. The tourist requested the man whether he would show him the way to airport. Now we are treating this request as a question only, and accordingly we change it, isn't it? Now you can treat this question in the format of request, in the format of the question as a request itself. Understood? Okay. When you treat it as a request, need you do all these things, whether and all? No need. Just like you change a ordinary request from active into passive, just with the help of to as link word, you can change it. Then how can you change it? The tourist requested the man what? Because the man to show him the way to airport. The tourist requested the man to show him the way to airport. That also is absolutely right, isn't it? Because even though this is a question, it is actually a request. A request introduced in the format of a question, isn't it? So you can treat it as a ordinary request also. There is nothing wrong in that. So both way you can do that. Both are right. What is the man's answer? The man: sorry, I don't know the way because I don't belong to this place. Sorry, he expressed sorrow. The man expressed sorrow and said that. The man expressed sorrow and said that. And the following you can add. Expressed sorrow also you can use, or regretted. He is showing his helplessness. Regret, isn't it? So, the man expressed sorrow and said that. Or The man regretted that. Both are right. The man regretted that, or the man expressed sorrow and said that, I don't know the way. He didn't know the way. I don't know. Simple person. It will go to simple person. He didn't know the way because I don't belong to this place. I don't belong to this place will become, he didn't belong to that place. He didn't belong. I don't. Simple person. He didn't belong to that place. Very simple. The tourist. Who can help me, sir? The tourist again asked the man. Asked the man. Who can help me then? Who can help me then? Who can help me? It will become who could. Who could help him? Who could help him is the tourist again asked the man, who could help him if so? Very simple. Okay. Only can will become could, that is all. And me will become him. The man, you ask that water driver, he may know the way. The man addressed. Okay. You ask that auto driver, isn't it? So it is a kind of address. Or you asked. What the right? Man asked the tourist, or the man addressed the tourist to ask that auto driver. The tourist, the man addressed the tourist, the man addressed the tourist to ask that auto driver. He may know the way. How will you connect this with this? Yes, or because. With yes or because, you can join those two sentences. The man addressed the tourist to ask that auto driver. As he may. May will become might. As he might know the way. Or because he might know the way. Okay, both are right. The man addressed the tourist to ask that auto driver, as he might know the way, because he might know the way. The tourist. Okay, thank you. What will you do? Okay, thank you. Can you reproduce the same in indirect also? No. You just convey this idea through other words. When he says, okay, thank you, he is agreeing, isn't it? Okay, thank you. You are thanking, isn't it? So, how will you change this? The tourist. He agreed and thanked. Okay, thank you. The tourist agreed and thanked. Okay, right? So, this is how you have to change different kinds of dialogues from direct into indirect. We will do one more, then we will wind up. Okay, right? See the dialogue between an old lady and the shopkeeper. Old lady, last I lost my purse. Shopkeeper, have you really taken it from your home? Yes, of course. It is only 5 minutes back I took money from it and paid the fishmonger, the fish seller. If so, where it has gone? That is what I to ask. Okay, so this is the dialogue between old lady and shopkeeper. Very simple. Just remember all the 5 rules that we discussed already, and just to try to do it yourself, and when I discuss, you just compare your answer with my answers. Okay, start. Your time starts now. I will give you some 1-1.5 minutes. That is enough. Okay, over. Right. Let us go through it. You old lady. Last, I lost my purse. Last, it is a cry of grief, sorrow, isn't it? So, how will you change this? Old lady. Last. When we were changing exclamatory sentence, I showed you different kinds of introductory words. Exclaimed, wondered, surprised, cried with joy, cried with sorrow, cried with fear, and all, isn't it? So which one is suitable here? Cried with sorrow. Because she lost her purse, isn't it? Old lady cried with sorrow. Cried with sorrow. Who tells what accordingly? We have to use the correct introductory words. The old lady cried with sorrow that, linga word is that, natural matter sentence. The old lady cried with sorrow that I lost my purse. The sentence is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. Very simple. I lost my purse will become, she had lost her purse. She had close to her purse. The old lady cried with sorrow that she had lost her purse. The shopkeeper, have you really taken it from your home? What question? Yes or no question? It is a yes or no question, whether or if we must use here. And question is in, this question is in which tense? Present perfect. It will go to past perfect, isn't it? So, how will you get? The shopkeeper asked the old lady, whether she, have you become had, past perfect. The shopkeeper asked the old lady whether she had, really taken it from your home will become her. The shopkeeper asked the old lady whether she had really taken it from her home. Full stop. The old lady, yes, of course. Yes, of course. How will you change? Give an emphatic positive reply. The old lady gave an emphatic positive reply saying that and said that in whatever manner you want you can do. The old lady gave an emphatic positive reply and said that it is only will become it moves only. Just to change the translation. The old lady gave an emphatic positive reply saying that and said that both you can do. The old lady gave an emphatic positive reply and said that it was only 5 minutes back that I took will become she had taken. I took is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. It was only 5 minutes back that she had taken money from it and paid. Again, paid will become had paid. Past perfect. And had paid the fishmonger. The shopkeeper. If so, where has it gone? The shopkeeper again asked the old lady. If so, where has it gone? Where has it gone will become where it had gone. Where it had gone. This is in present perfect. It will go to past perfect. And in a statement, auxiliary verb will come after the subject. Isn't it? Okay. The shopkeeper again asked the old lady, if so, where it had gone. Okay. Where has it gone? Where it had gone. Okay. Okay. What is the reply of the old lady? Yes. That is what I do ask. Very simple. The old lady replied that was what she too asked. Very simple. The old lady replied him or told him that. The old lady told him that or replied him that. That is what will become that was what. The old lady replied him that was what I too will become she too. Ask will become asked. Asked. So the old lady told him or replied him that was what she too asked. Okay, very simple. So this is how you have to change different kinds of sentences, different kinds of dialogues from direct into indirect. Now we have completed all the rules. Change of tense, change of persons, change of all kinds of sentences into statement, change of certain words, removal of inverted commas, all the rules we have discussed. So I think you are capable of changing any kind of sentence from direct into indirect. If you clearly remember, properly remember all these 5 rules, any kind of sentence you can change. You are equipped with every rule and everything now. So I think let us make a quick recap and write up things. So what is the first and foremost rule that we have to Bear in mind when we change a sentence from direct to indirect, change of tense. Okay, very simple, we already discussed. If the direct sentence is in present tense, it will go to corresponding past. And if the direct sentence is in simple past, it will go to past perfect. If the direct sentence is in past continuous, it will go to past perfect continuous. And if the direct sentence is in past perfect or past perfect continuous, it will remain unchanged. And in future, whatever future it is, we have to use auxiliary would. Okay? And if we have auxiliary verb like can, etc., that also will go to its corresponding past. Then change of persons. What is change of persons? Yes, symbol. All first person will go to third person. Second person will go to either first person or into third person, according to the demand of the context. And if we have a third person pronoun in the direct speech, it remains unchanged. Okay. Then change of all kinds of sentences into statement or a declarative sentence. Whether direct sentence is a question, command, request, exclamation, wish, whatever it may be, everything will become a statement. And in this regard, I have shown you a column. When we change different kinds of sentences, we have to use the appropriate introductory word and an appropriate ling word. What are the different introductory words that we have to use when we convert different kinds of sentences? I have shown you in that column. And the ling word also I have shown. When we change a statement, that must be used as ling word. When we change a question, if it is a question word question, same question word must be used as ling word. If it is a yes or no question, whether or if must be used as ling word. And when we change command, request, etc., to will be the ling word. And the last, while we change exclamatory sentence from direct to indirect, again, that will be the ling word. That everything we discussed. Yes, the next rule is change of certain words. Change of certain words, that is very simple. I have already told you what are the changes that happen to certain words when we change a sentence from direct to indirect. Words showing nearness will become words showing distance. Very simple. This, that, these, those, here, there, now, then, today, that day, tomorrow, the next day, or the following day, and so on. Isn't it? Come will become go. That also please remember. So, that is very simple. And the last one is removal of inverted commas. So, always direct speech is put within double inverted comma. And just before the starting of the direct speech, there will be a comma. So, in indirect speech, we have to remove all these commas. And it will be a mere statement only. So, these are the five rules that you have to bear in mind when you change a sentence from direct to indirect. If you remember all these five rules properly, you can change any kind of sentence. Whether it is command, request, wish, exclamation, question, whatever it may be, you can change sentences. So I think now you are fully confident and you are fully equipped to change any kind of dialogue in any kind of sentence from direct to indirect. But you must remember all these analysis, all these five rules simultaneously work in your brain. You are bound to go wrong. When you remember one rule, please don't forget two rules. Remember all the five rules properly. Okay, so that is it. Okay, by that we are coming to the conclusion of this session. Session of direct and indirect. I hope you liked the session. If you enjoyed the session, please don't forget to click the like icon. And if you wish to subscribe the channel, that also you can do. So most probably in the next class, we'll be doing transformation of sentences. So till we meet with the transformation of sentence, okay, take care.